Hello students, today's MEP lecture, myself Archana Chaugule. Before we will start our lecture number 13 for MEP, we will revise what we learned in the last lecture. What we learned in the last two lectures actually, we learned different instruction sets of 8051. Which include, in the last lecture we learn bit manipulation instructions of 8051 and program control instructions of 8051. When we talk about bit manipulation instruction of 8051, it works on the single bits, which include logical and logical or port bits, which work on the single bits. Then we have program control instructions, which control the program, which include conditional jump instruction, unconditional jump instructions. Now today we are going to learn 8051 assembly level programming language. Already we know that assembly level programming language is called as low level language or middle level language. That means logically, after the machine means hardware, there is a machine code, that is a binary code. Then we having assembly code where we can write the instructions. In the instruction we having the opcode and the operand. For example, on the slide we can see move P0 comma hash FFH. What is there? MOV is mnemonics. It is a part of the instruction which represent the operation code. And what is the operand here? Operand, we are performing the operation on P0 and the data FFH. What we are doing here? We are transferring FFH data to the port P0. We know that in 8051, when we talk about the assembly code, it required assembler. What is assembler? It's a translator which translate assembly code into the machine code. So what are the main elements of assembly language programming? When you talk about the assembly language programming, we must be know assembler directives. Then we must be know different instruction sets of that particular processor or controller, and what are the different addressing modes of that processor or controller. Here we are going to learn assembly language programming for 8051. So we must be know what are the different instruction sets of 8051, which already we learned in the last two lectures. We having different arithmetic instructions, different logical instruction, different bit manipulation instruction, different rotate instructions, different program control instructions. Now before that, we learn different addressing modes of 8051. We know that 8051 having implied addressing mode, then immediate addressing mode, register addressing mode, direct addressing mode, external memory addressing mode, stack addressing mode, index addressing mode. So how you are specifying the instruction, depending upon that we have different addressing modes. So main two elements of 8051 programming already we learned, that is instruction sets of 8051 and addressing modes of 8051. On the slide we can see that the flow of 8051 assembly code. When we want to write the code in the assembly language, we having the file name .asm, which we can write in any editors. For example, Notepad. Once you return the code, we have to save with .asm. Then it will be go to the assembler who translate this .asm file into the .obj file, means convert that .obj file. Then there is a linker which will be link obj file and convert into .exe file. That means it is an executable file on the machine. This is a simple flow of assembly code to file executable code. Now we are going to learn what is assembler directives. From the name itself, we can say that it gives the directions to the CPU, means it gives the commands or tell or help the CPU how to execute the assembly code or what written in the assembly code. Most useful directives of 8051s, I listed only four here. First one ORG, that is origin. Then second one DB, that is define byte. Then third one EQU, equate. And the last one END, end. So here ORG is indicate the start of the program. So if you are writing ORG and some address 0000H, it indicate the starting address of the memory where we can start the assembly program or assembly code. So it give the direction to the CPU, the starting address of the program is 000H. Instead of that, I can write ORG 1000H, means it give the direction to the CPU, the starting address of this program is 1000H. Next, DB. DB stands for defined byte. It is used to declare the string, that is a string of bytes. For example, DB, double quotation, you can write any string. For example, here I written DB EDGEFX. So it will be declaring the string. Okay, that is a string byte. Then next EQU, equate, which used to equate the address of the variable. For example, REG EQU, 09H. What it indicate? If I call this EQU, if you declare the EQU with REG with 09H, means REG now assigned the value is 09H. So when the program I want to use the 09H, I can write the variable name as MOVREG, #2H. That means we are moving #2H to the REG. And then end, which indicate the end of the program. This is again the important directive of the assembler, which help 8051 to understand the assembly code. So there are four different assembler directives we studied now. ORG, which indicate the starting address of the program, that is starting address of the memory. DB, define the byte of the string. EQU, equate, is give the equivalent address of the variable. And the last is end, which indicate the end of the program. Now we will see simple programming of 8051. If you are using arithmetic instructions of 8051, we can write simple program. So here ORG 0000H indicate the starting address of the memory location, and END indicate the end of the program. In that we are writing only three instructions. What is the first one? MOV move R0, #03H. Hash means 03H is a data. That data we are moving to the register R0. The next, move A, #05H. Means 05 is data, we are moving to accumulator. Then I am using the instruction ADD add A, R0H. What it will be do? It will be add the content of R0, which register A. A result is stored in the A, that is accumulator. And then end. So this is an example for addition of two numbers. If we go for the multiplication of two numbers, what the changes will become in the program? Instead of add, I can write mul A, R0H, which will be perform the multiplication of 03 with 05. So what is the result after the first program of the addition? 03 plus 05 means 08H. What is the result of the multiplication? 03 multiplied by 05 means answer is 15. That is 15H, which will be stored in accumulator, that is register A. Same thing when you go for subtraction and the division. What the changes will be come in the program? For subtraction, we have the instruction SUBB, and for division, we having DIV instruction. So these are simple programs in assembly language for 8051 to perform four arithmetic operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Now next we will see how we can write the program using logical instructions. So we know that there are three different logical instructions present in 8051: logical OR, logical AND, and logical XOR. For example, if I am writing move a comma hash 20h, that means I am moving 20h data to register A. Then I am writing move r0 comma hash 03h, that means I am transferring 03h into the r0. Now when we write ORL, logical OR, a comma r0, that means is performing logical OR operation on content of A with the content of r0. This is a bit manipulation instructions. It will be work on the bits of r0 with the bits of A. But what is the operation between these two? Logical OR. For example, we know that what is the binary value of 20001000000. What is the binary value of 03101? Remaining are the extra zeros to match the length of 20 with the length of 3. Now, when we perform logical OR, we know that if any one bit out of 2 is 1, output is 1. So, when we perform logical OR operation with these bits 0, 1, in the 0 and 1, what is the output for logical OR? 1. Then we have the next bit, that is a bit number 2nd of A, and R0 is 00. So output will be 0. The next 3rd bit of A is 0, and 3rd bit of R0 is 1. So output is 1. If we continue this way, what the output we will get? 00100101. This is logical OR operations output. If we use same data with logical AND, we know that if both the bits are 1, then only we will get the output will be 1, otherwise 0. So in the second example, we can see the 0th bit of A and R0 is 01, so output is 0. Next bit 00, output is 0. Third bit 010000000. But when we talk about the next bit of A and R0, that is 6th bit of A is 1 and 6th bit of R0 is 1. So both the inputs are 1, output will be 1, and remaining are 00. So logical AND operation, what is the output for same data? 00000100. Then when we go for logical XOR operation, if I am writing XRL A comma R0, it will perform logical XOR operation. In the XOR, we know that if both the inputs are different, output will be 1, otherwise 0. So we will get the output for XOR 00100001. Now we will go for the next example of assembly language programming. What is the question here? You have to write the assembly language program to transfer the 10 bytes of data from one memory location to another memory location, where the first location is 30H and starting location of this is 30, and then another location is 50H, where starting location is 50H. 10 bytes we have to transfer. Okay, so we require the counter value is 10, that is in the hexadecimal is 0AH. So how we write the program? First we will move R0 comma hash 30H, means now starting address of R0 is 30H. Then move R1 comma hash 50H, means starting address of the R1 is 50H now. Then we are declaring the R3 as a counter with 10 because we want to transfer the 10 bytes. So move R3 comma hash 0AH, which we can write hash 10H also in the decimal. D stand for the decimal. Then we are writing loop move A comma at the rate R0. What it will be perform is an indirect addressing mode where the content of the location which is pointed by R0, here is 30, is copied to accumulator because starting address of R0 is 30H. The first location is 30, content which is pointed by R0 move to the accumulator. Then in the next move at the rate R1 comma A, that means we are now transferring the content from register A to the next location which are pointed by R1. Here R1 is pointed, the first location is 50H. That means the first byte we are transfer from 30H to 50H. Then we increment the R0 and R1 with INC, which will be go to the next location of R0 and R1. That means now next location is 31H and in the R1 51H. Then what it doing? DJNZ R3 comma loop. What will do? It will be decrement jump if not 0 to loop. But what will be decrement? It will be decrement the R3. What we are storing in the R3 is a counter. So it will be now after the first execution of this instruction. What is the value of R3 now? 9. So it is 0? No. So it will go back to the loop. And where is the loop is there? Loop move A comma at the rate R0. That means next location pointed by R0 copy to the A. Then from A to the R1, that means next location of R1 is 51H. And this will be continue for 10 times. Means 30 to 39 and 50 to 59, where we can transfer the content from one memory location to another memory location with the counter value is 10, which we are storing in the R3. Then R3 will become 0 after the 10, so it will be stop. That is stop, SJMP stop, which will be terminate the program. So this type of the example they can ask in the exam to transfer the some data from one memory location to another memory locations. Sometimes they will mention the locations like this example 30H and 50H. Sometime you have to assume. Now next, write a program to toggle the port 1 bits. We know that it is possible to use the ports as an input and output by writing the programs for that. And we can program some bits of the port also. So port bits are bit manipulation possible. That means using bit manipulation instructions, we can program some bits of the ports or single bit of the ports. So here we are toggling the ports. That means we want all the bits at 0101 after some time. So how will write the program for this? See, here ORG 00H, that means starting address is 00H. Then I am writing toggle is a label colon move P1 comma has 01H. That means I am moving some data. Here is a 1 to port 1, that is P1. Then I am calling some delay. After that delay, I am writing the move A comma P1, means move the content of P1 to the accumulator. Then CPL A, complement the value of A, means complement the value of P1. Directly also I can write complement CPL P1, which will be complement the P1. So instead of directly complementing, what we are writing here, we are first moving from P1 to A and then complementing A. Then move a comma p1, that means after complementing the value of p1 which is stored in the a, again move to the p1. So if p1 before the complement, what is the value is there? 0000001. Then after the complement, what the value will get? 1111110. Means before complement there are 70 and 11. After complement, what the A having or P having? 71 and 10. That means 0 replaced with 1 and 1 replaced with 0. And then we are calling delay. That means there is a 0 and 1, there is some delay. Then HJMP toggle, short jump to the toggle. It will be again go back to that and it will be continuously execute or complement the bits of port 1, 0 with 1, 1 with 0. Now, what is the delay? We have to write the program for the delay, that is subroutine. Delay subroutine. Delay move R5 comma hash 10 means loading 10 to R5. Then move R6 comma hash 200. We are loading or moving 200 to R6. Same thing for the second. Move R7 comma hash 200. Again we are loading 200 to the R7. Then we are decrementing DJNZ. Decrement R7 jump if not 0 to the hash. Then decrement jump if not 0 to R6, which will go second. And then decrement jump if not 0 to R5, which will go to the third. And then RET, return to the main program. Always we have to write the RET instruction at the end of the subroutine, which will return your program to the main program. And then end of the main program. So it will be continuously after some time, after some delay, it will be toggle the bits of port 1, that is P1. This is a simple program to toggle the bits of port 1. Same thing we can write for the port 2, port 3, port 0 also. So what is the summary of today's lecture? What we learn? We learn assembly level programming elements, which include assembler directives, then instruction sets and addressing modes. Then we learn today what are the different assembler directives required to write the assembly code, which include ORG, N, EQUET and DB, that is defined byte. Then we learn some simple examples in assembly language programming, which includes we using arithmetic and logical instructions to write the programs. Then we learn how to toggle the bits of ports. Then we learn how to transfer the data from one location to another location using some instructions. So you have to use the book MASIDI 8051 microcontroller embedded system using assembly and the C. So in your syllabus you are going to learn 8051 assembly code. And some references here I put as a websites which I use during the preparation of this PPT. Thank you. If you're having any doubts regarding today's lecture, you can ask me. I assign some question for your assignment. You must be know what is assembler directives, what are the elements of assembly language programming. Then you are able to write simple example of assembler directives. Then you must be know how many steps are needed to write the assembly code.